From the beginning, we were wrong.
Oh, sure, it's easy to say that now, but you were with everybody else when we started.
Have we begun to understand the mistakes we have made?
Wait, I can read that language. That's not what that says. That was a recipe for rhubarb tort.
In a world awakened to new magic.
Ooh, you can tell those guys are the big men on campus.
Their frat has a weird dress code. On this rising
tide. They're gonna go push a nerd into a locker and then high-five each other.
A force powerful enough to twist even the...
Well, well, well. Laying down on the job again, huh? Uh-oh.
Oh, I'm so relaxed. That just relieved all the tension in my back.
The new king of the Winter Court surprised us all.
He hid inside the cake.
Oh my god!
He was all that other Fae were not. Aggressive, ambitious, visionary.
So basically he was the first Fae to be like, hey, why don't we just kill them all?
Oh yeah. Hold still, you've got a really nasty bug crawling up your back. Got it.
Gadflo and his followers, the two of them.
Isn't Gadflo a kind of toilet?
That a new god was to be born in the east, beneath Gadflo's crystalline fortress of Amethan.
Oh, no way. Amethan is my birthstone. God, I was born in Apruary.
Against the young races of Amalur. Against a mortal army, no matter the power of their god, we might have been victorious.
Like, don't get me wrong, we sucked, but it makes us look a lot worse than we actually were. Rules
of life and death. Each two of us are fallen on the battlefield would soon rise again. For the Fae do not know death as we do.
What the hell? That's not fair.
I'm amazed there's any humans left at all. If the Fae are that long lived and immortal, you think just by population expansion they would have pushed the humans out.
Fae are like pandas. They have very low sex drive.
We knew that it was only a matter of time. Our fate had been written. At least, that is what we believed. Until you died.
Wait, I died? That doesn't sound like something I would do.
Yeah, it turns out you were the problem. When you died, everything got better.
Witness all the people who have died. This game is actually about collecting equipment from battlefield corpses.
I feel like that is a genre that has not been exploited sufficiently in the video game world.
Oh my god, what a good sleep. Oh, man, what smells?
Wait. Where'd the cards come from? Oh, maybe they weren't actually fighting. Maybe they're Yu-Gi-Oh! Battling.
To the death.
Isn't Yu-Gi-Oh! Always played to the death?
I assume so. I don't know anyone who plays it, so I guess they're all dead.
Good man rolling.
What do you think this one is then? Alpha? Doran? Could even be a Jotun. Always a surprise, eh, Gran?
Eyes on the job, boy.
Boy? I'm 48.
Dead's dead. And be thankful for that. All we've seen.
Go Look, on and pull there's no reason why you have to be a if dick about this, okay?
One way or the other.
In brief character creation, huzzah!
What of the human women? Looks
Wait, we have to figure out all the character creation stuff just so our corpse is gonna look right?
These our main women. Wound tighter than a Varani crossbow.
I think that's either racist or sexist or both. I don't know the references.
You know he'll want all the details.
Amazing how well the body held up. Better than I've seen.
Why are you so concerned about the state of the body? That seems kind of creepy to me. Under a lucky
star, this one. If you combine their facial hair, they still don't have a full beard. They're missing the chin.
Yeah, they need a guy with a soul patch. I think we're done.
Put her with the others. What, why are you tell? You're the one driving. Why are you telling me to put her somewhere? What the? Oh. Sure. Edith. Edith? Edith.
Well, that's it for you then. Better luck next time.
So that's it? Man, CSI Amalur was not a very interesting show. Ugh. Oh man, how drunk was that? Oh no. Oh no.
I'm trying to imagine myself in that situation, and there's just no logical end to the vomiting.
Yep.
It's just constant vomit for the rest of my life.
I like the green smoke coming off the bodies. That has a nice effect.
Oh wait, she doesn't even have shoes.
Oh, that makes it so much worse.
Ugh.
I think I'd rather just be naked and have shoes than the other way around. Like, ugh.
I need to go have a bath and just exfoliate all of my skin.
Alright, memo to self, don't die. I mean, on the plus side, I guess most people don't have this kind of learning experience.
I'll say this, there's a certain purity to waking up in a pile of corpses, because no matter what happens, tomorrow, you're gonna wake up somewhere better. There's nothing worse than that.